happens? ZA2 is equal to ZB2 is equal to ZC2. And in a symmetrical system, and also the current A2 is zero, and therefore I neutral is equal to zero. That is the current flowing towards the load. Your negative sequence component current. And then the zero sequence component current will also be the same. Again, we have two voltages applicable, VAN0, which is IA0 times ZA0, or VN0, which is IN times ZN. So therefore, you will see that VN0 is 3 times IA0 times Z0. And there is our equivalent circuit. VAE is the voltage with respect to Earth. Now, if we look at the symmetrical delta connected load, remember, in order to represent this on a per phase basis, it is necessary to obtain the equivalent star so that we can have a neutral point. So this is then the equivalent star circuit for this delta load. Now, as the delta has no earth connection, the equivalent star circuit will not have its neutral earth. The positive negative zero sequence will then be exactly the same as those for an unearthed star connection. Now, if you look at the sequence circuits for a symmetrical transmission line and a transformer, they all look the same. We have a positive sequence, negative sequence, and a zero sequence. Now, if we look at the sequence circuits for a synchronous machine, there's a little bit of a difference there. We have an induced EMF, then we have ZA1 and a current flowing out from this. The negative sequence doesn't have any voltage associated with it, the same with the zero sequence. And if we use Kirchhoff's voltage laws, we can say that VAN1 is equal to EAN1 minus IA1 ZA1. Now, for the is minus IA2 ZA2. There's no induced EMF, therefore. Kirchhoff's law. Yeah. The current is going outside. All right. And the zero sequence, VAN0 is equal to minus IA0 times ZA. You'll have to brush up on Kirchhoff's voltage law. Remember, it's an alternator, it supplies a current. So if the current is flowing outwards, and we have VAN0, the current is flowing in that direction, which is IA0, and that is IAZA. So the current is entering this side, and it's leaving that side, so our voltage is IA0, ZA0. And because these two are opposing, we have VAN0 is equal to minus IA0, ZA0. Use Kirchhoff's law, we're going to say let's go around that loop. Then we will have VAN0 plus IA0 ZA0 is equal to 0 because there's no induced EMF. Therefore, VAN0 is equal to minus IA0 ZA0. Right. Now, on the next slide, we have an example. We must draw the sequence diagram for an alternator feeding a transmission line if the alternator is solidly earthed. Now, there you can see what we normally do is we have our alternator. The positive sequence. So that's the positive sequence for the alternator. Now we're going to have the positive sequence of the line. So that will be VAN1. And the current flowing out there will be IA. This will be Z alternator, positive, and Z line, positive. And then we can simplify it to this equivalent circuit. And this is then ZA1 total, which is equal to Z of the alternator plus Z of the line. Okay. Now for the negative phase sequence, it will look exactly the same, where that will be VAN1, VAN2, and where we have ZA2 total will be Z of the alternator plus Z check of the line. Negative sequence. And then for the zero sequence, we will have the same thing, which is VAN0. And again, it will be Z alternator 0 plus Z line 0. Now, where they say that the alternator was solidly earthed, this is the effect that it has there. We have no neutral connected to this. Now, the second one, the alternator, is earthed through an impedance. What happened to solution 2? Okay. The only difference that we are going to have is when we have Z in there. And that is now for with a earthing resistor or impedance, then Z0 total is going to be Z alternator 0 plus Z line 0 plus 3Zn. Okay. Yes. Only on the zero sequence. The earthing, they stay the same. And if the alternator is not earthed, then we have a little bit of a problem. The positive is the same, negative is the same, but if it's not earthed, there's no path for the zero sequence currents to flow. Okay, and there we have our solution number 2. It's a different page, okay. Now, if you look at the sequence circuits for star and delta transformers, positive negative sequence circuits are the same. The zero circuit depends on the connection of the transformer windings. Now, the following is helpful to determine the zero sequence of any three-phase transformer. Now, if we look at this, this is the high voltage side, A and A dash, and the low voltage side is lowercase a, and A dash. Now A dash are links that can be closed and opened depending on the connection of the winding. A and A are closed if the respective windings is star connected and earthed. Okay, so let's look at that. We have a star connection which is earthed on both sides of the transformer. So our equivalent circuit then, that is Z0 of the transformer . Now they say if it's star connected in and earthed, then that one is closed and that one is closed. So our final equivalent circuit then will look like that. Z0. Now if we go back, A dash and A dash are closed if the respective windings is delta connected. Let's just have a look there. Let's make it blue. So for a delta connection, that one is closed and that one is closed. Well, let me redraw this because it... I'm taking my time explaining this to you because it's important when we start with the fault calculations. So if it's a delta connection, that one and that one is closed. So you can see these are open and therefore no zero sequence currents will be able to flow. All right, that's the most important part. All right, A dash and small a dash is open for earthed and unearthed connections. Okay, there's an example. No zero sequence current will flow. So therefore, if we look at a star-star with both sides connected, then we have A and A connected. There we have a star, the high voltage side is a neutral connected, and the star on the low voltage side is open, and that is what our equivalent circuit then looks like. So therefore no zero sequence currents will flow after the transformer. Then if we look at a YND connection, YN, so that means the high voltage is star with the earth, and therefore capital A is closed. Delta connection on the lower low voltage side, therefore lowercase a prime is closed. So we will have current flowing from the alternator up to the transformer. After the transformer, no zero sequence current will flow, because that is an open circuit there. I'll show you just now. Let's say we have an alternator with its impedance connected to a transformer and then connected to a transmission line. So this is Z of the alternator, Z of the transformer, and Z line. Now let's say we have a star delta connection, then the negative, positive, negative will be the same, but the zero sequence, now we start with that. First of all, there is the alternator's impedance, and then we go to the transformer, which is connected like that. And that goes to the line. Now, this is Z alternator, Z transformer, Z line. Now, if we have a delta connection on the secondary side, that will be closed. And star with a neutral, that one will close. So the only circulating current will be IA0 up to the transformer. After the transformer, this line will have positive and negative zero and sequence circuits, but no zero sequence current flowing. Okay. Pardon? Yes, it's earth on the prime high voltage side. Delta, you can't earth, woman. But I told you that it was there. Okay. Now, the phase shift of sequence components in three-phase transformers. If we look at the vector group DY1 and YD1, the positive sequence looks like that. Now, if we look at the line voltage, we have VAN1 is VAN, and it leads by 30 degrees. Or if we look at it the other way, VAN1 lags VAN line by 30 degrees. The same will happen with the current. Yes. No, this is nothing to do with the power factor. This is just the phase shift across the transformer due to the type of connections. Right, so let's look at the negative phase sequence. It's just the opposite. Here you can see that VAN1 leads the line voltage. Phase voltage leads the phase, the line voltage by 30 degrees in a negative. So it's just the opposite of a positive phase sequence. Okay. Yeah, remember, if we look at DY1, our transformer connection, remember a phase it always rotates anti-clockwise? So this is the high voltage, and that's the low voltage, and there's our 30 degrees phase shift. It rotates anti-clockwise. So you can see that the low voltage lags the high voltage by 30 degrees. Because any point you look, you will first find the high voltage component will come first, and then 30 degrees later your low voltage. That is for a YND1 or a DYN1. That's a 1 o'clock. That's our clock number. If you will think back to machines 3, which you did in the previous millennium, if we look then at YND11, it is 11 o'clock. That's our high voltage winding, and that's the low voltage winding, and there's the 30 degrees phase shift. Here you can see that the low voltage leads the high voltage. Okay. And now remember, for negative sequence, it's just the opposite. And here we have low voltage is equal to... Yeah. Negative sequence component. It's always like that. It depends on your transformer connection group. Why do you want to cram it? You know the phasor diagram. Just look at it and derive it. It's always there. It's always 30 degrees or minus 30 degrees. Either 1 o'clock or 11 o'clock connection. The what? The connection determines whether it's leading or lagging. Woman, I think you should go back to machines 3 and look at the transformer connections there. Well, let me just find this in the book. When I'm done, I'll show you where it is in the book. Right, let's look at an example. An alternator is connected to a YND1 transformer feeding a transmission line. The following data is applicable. We have a 100 MVA alternator at 11 kV. Our positive and negative sequence components is 0.2 per unit, zero sequence is 0.15. As you will remember, as we have previously said, the transformer positive and negative sequence components are the same. The same for an alternator. And then the transformer is 100 MVA, 132 to 11 kV, with a reactance of 9%. The current flowing in the transmission line, IA is 184 at an angle of 82.8, IB is 276 at an angle minus 41.4, IC is 230 at an angle of 180 degrees. We have to determine the alternator terminal windings. First step is to calculate the base current. We normally take the alternator as the base. So therefore, it will be 100 divided by square root through divided by 132, which gives us a current of 437.38 amps. So now we change everything to per unit. So IA will be IA divided by I base, which gives us 0.421 at an angle of 82. IB is IB divided by I base. 276 divided by 437, which gives us 0.631. Then IC, the same thing, 230 divided by 437, which gives us a current of 0.526 per unit. And now if we determine we have the line currents, we want the component, and therefore that's 1/3 of that matrix times the line currents. And if we multiply that out, we get this answer there, which is 0.521, angle 73.6, and 0.123 at an angle minus 139. As only positive and negative sequence current can flow in the lines feeding the delta connection, there's no zero sequence current for a YND1. Eh? So IA is that, and IA2 is that. And now if we want to know what the terminal voltage of the alternator is, VA1 is EA1 minus IAZ. That gives us 1.1 at an angle of minus 31.53 per unit. VA2 is minus IA2 ZA2, which is 0.024 at an angle of 160. Now we have the zero sequence components. We want to convert it to line values. And therefore, VA, VB, Z, and we see equal to the matrix times that, which gives us 1.2 at an angle of minus 32.8 and 1.03 at angle minus 155 degrees and 108 angle 93.85. So, yes. Yes, it must be always that minus 1 minus 30 is always the same as the transformer connection. So if it was a YND1, then it would be 30 degrees. Or a YND11, that's 30 degrees, no? Right. Okay. We'll have a 5-minute break.